हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू टू दी ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ अरिहंत इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल. माय नेम इज लक्ष्मी बड़गू. दिस इज़ द वीडियो फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 7th सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न लेसन नंबर 3, HCF एंड LCM, दैट इज हाईएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर एंड लोएस्ट कॉमन मल्टीप्लायर. Before going to start the topic, first of all we will understand what is meaning by prime number, composite number, co-prime number and twin prime numbers. Okay, so first of all, prime number means what? A number which has only two factors. Okay, a number which has only two factors, that is one and the another number is own number, that is the number is itself, is called a prime number. Okay, so let we'll see the examples of prime number. Prime number has only two factors. See here, 2. First one example is 2. 2 has only two factors. One is 1 and another number is itself, that is 2. And 3 also prime number because 3 also present in one table and 3 table only. If we are taking 4, 4 is not a prime number because 4 is divisible by 1, 4 is divisible by 2 and 4 is divisible by 4. Here more than 2 factors are there, that's why 4 is not a prime number. Now let's we will take the 7. 7 also present in one table and 7 table. If we are taking 9, 9 is not a prime number because 9 is divisible by 3 also, means it is present in one table, 3 table and 9 table. Okay students, means what is meaning by prime number? A number which has only two factors, one and the number itself, then only we can say that given number is a prime number. Okay, like this we can see the so many examples, students. Okay, and next one, composite number. Composite number means what? A number which has more than two factors. It's called composite number. Means we can take here 4 because 4 has more than two factors. And we can see that 10 also we can take. 10 has more than two factors. That is, 10 is present in one table, 2 table, 5 table and then 10 table. Okay. Understood the difference between the prime number and composite number? Prime number has only two factors, one and the number itself, and composite number has a more than two factors. Okay. Now we will see co-prime numbers. Co-prime numbers means what? The numbers which have only one as their common factor are called co-prime numbers, or relatively prime number, or mutually prime numbers. Okay, let's we will see one example, means we will understand. Any two consecutive natural numbers are also said to be co-prime numbers, students. Now see one example. Consider 4 and 15. Now first of all we have to take the factors of 4. 4 is present in 1 table, 2 table and 4 table. Now 15 is present in 1 table, 3 table, 5 table and 15 table. Now we will see the common factor of 4 and 15. See how many common factors are there in 4 and 15? Only one. Okay, now we can say that the number 4 and 15 are co-prime numbers. Okay students, understood co-prime numbers means what? The number which have only one as the common factor. Okay, then only we can say that the given two numbers are co-prime numbers, or relatively prime number, or mutually prime numbers. And any two consecutive natural numbers are also co-prime numbers, means assume that 9 and 10. Okay, these are consecutive numbers, these are also co-prime numbers because factors of 9 are 1, 3, 9 and factors of 10 are 1, 2, 5, 10. Here see, common number is only one. That's why always remind that any two consecutive natural numbers are co-prime numbers. Okay. So, twin prime numbers, again fourth one is there. What is meaning by twin prime numbers? See, if the difference between two co-prime numbers is 2, then the numbers are called as a twin prime numbers. See, once again I am reading, if the difference between two coprime numbers is 2, difference is 2, then the numbers are said to be twin prime numbers. Okay, from the coprime numbers we have to see that the difference is 2, then only we can say that they are the twin prime numbers. And there are total 8 pairs of twin prime numbers are there between 1 to 100. From 1 to 100, how many pairs are there, students? Only 8 pairs of twin prime numbers are there. And what are they, that we will see. See, first one is 3, 5. See, these are the twin prime numbers. Why? See the difference between the 3 and 5. 5 minus 3, how much? 5 minus 3 is 2. So the difference is 2. That's why these are said to be twin prime numbers. Now 5, 7, we will take. 7 minus 5 is 2. That's why this is also twin prime number. And again 11, 13. 11 is prime number, 13 also prime number. The difference between 11 and 13 is 2. That's why these are the twin prime numbers. Okay. And next one, 17 and 19. 19 minus 17 is 2. That's why this pair also twin prime number. And afterwards, 19 afterwards, 31 is there. 19. 23 is there, 23, and 25 is not a prime number, that's why we can't take. 27 also not prime number. 29 is a prime number. After 29, 31. 29 and 31 difference is 2. So this is one pair of twin prime number. And next one is 41, 43 and 59, 61. Okay, total again one pair is there, that is the last pair is 71 and 73. Total 8 twin prime numbers are there from 1 to 100, students. Okay. And here in prime number and in composite number, one is not there, students. You observe that one is there. What? Your prime number example, we started from the 2, and in composite number example is we started from the 4, students. There then one is neither prime and nor composite number. Why? Because what is the condition for the prime number? Prime number has only two factors, and the composite number condition is a number which has more than two factors, that are said to be composite number. Now for one, it has only one factor, that is the one itself only. So it is neither prime nor composite. One is said to be unity. Okay. What is one? One is said to be unity always. It is neither prime nor composite number. Okay, students. I hope all of you understood what is meaning by prime number, composite number, coprime number, twin prime numbers. Now, we will see that practice set 10. See which number is neither prime nor composite number. Just now I told which number it is. Yes, correct. One is neither prime nor composite number. Now second one, which of the following pairs of coprimes? See here, total 8, 4 pairs are given. Which are the coprime numbers that we have to see here? While teaching coprime number, I told any two consecutive natural numbers are coprime numbers. Now see here, we can say that 8, 14 is a coprime numbers. What, students? No. And again 4, 5 we can take. 4, 5 are the consecutive natural numbers, so these are the coprime numbers. And 17 and 19 are also said to be coprime number. Just now I told these are the twin prime numbers. And 27 and 15 both are present in 3 table, no, students? So first one and fourth one are not pair of coprime numbers, but second and third one are the pair of coprime numbers. Okay, students. Now question number 3, list the prime numbers from 25 to 100 and say how many they are. From 25 to 100, how many prime numbers are there, that we have to write now. Okay, after 25, 26 is prime number. What, students? No, 26 is not prime number. 27, no. 28 also not a prime number. 29, yes, 29 is a prime number. Now we will see that the numbers between 25 to 100, how many prime numbers are there. See, after 29, 30 is present in 3 table, so it is not a prime number. 31, 31 is a prime number because it is not present in any table. 32 is divisible by 2 and 4 and 8. 33 is present in 11 table, don't take. 34 also divisible by 2, okay. And then 37 is not present in any table, okay. 38 is divisible by 2, 39 also present in table. Now 41 is not divisible by any number. 43, 47, 53, 59, 61, 67, 71, 73, 79, 83, 89 and 97. These all numbers are not present in any table. So therefore, there are total 16 prime numbers are there. Okay. So question number 4C, write all twin prime numbers from 51 to 100. Just now I told total 8 pairs of prime numbers are there. So from 51 to 100, total how many pairs are there that we will see? Yes, only 2 pairs are there, that is 59-61 and 71-73. Okay, these 2 are there, these 2 twin prime numbers are there between 51 to 100. And next question C, write 5 pairs of twin prime numbers from 1 to 50. From 1 to 50 total 6 pairs are there, from that we can write any 5 pairs. That is C, 2,3, 5,7, 11,13, 17,19, 31. Okay, 29,31, and again last one pair also is there, that is 41,43 also is there. Now next one, question number 6 we will see. What is question number 6? See, which are the even prime numbers? Now all prime numbers are odd numbers leaving 2, because only 2 is a even prime number, rest all prime numbers are odd numbers. Okay students, remind it, only 2 is a even prime number, rest all prime numbers are odd numbers, and 2 is a smallest prime number. 2 is the smallest prime number. Okay, see the answer, there is only even prime number which is 2. Now we will see that the factorizing a number into its prime factors means what? We have to factorize the given numbers into its prime factors means we have to write that numbers into in the form of the prime numbers by doing the multiplication. Okay, so first of all, see here, to write a given numbers as a product of its a prime factor is to factorize number into the primes. Once again I'll read, to write a given number as a product of its a prime factors is to factorize the number into primes. Okay, see here, one example, factorize 56 into primes means what? We have to write the factors of 56 in the form of the prime numbers. There are 2 methods are there. One is horizontal method, that is horizontal arrangement and vertical arrangement. This is the vertical arrangement, students. See here, first of all we have to see that 56, unit place is 6. Now last year we studied the divisibility test for the 2, 3, 5, 11. Okay, that we will see now. What is the divisibility test for the 2 at unit place? The 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. If these numbers are present, then we can say that the number is divisible by 2. Now here 6 is there, means it is divisible by 2. No students, see, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 1 is remain, 1 and 6 is 16, into table 16 is there, no? That is 2 8s are 16. Okay, now again 28 is divisible by 2, no, because at unit place 8 is there. So once again do the division like that only. 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. Now 14, 4 is at unit place 4 is there, then again it is divisible by 2. 2 7s are 14. Now 7 is a prime number, so 7 is divisible by 7 only. 7 1s are 7. So the factors of 56 are 2 into 2 into 2 into 7. Do the multiplication. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 56 is there, no students? This is the vertical arrangement, horizontal arrangement also is there. See, same method, 56 means what? 28 into 2. Now, we have to take the factors of 28 now. That is 2 into 2 into 14. Now, we have to take the factors of 14. That is 2 into 2, 2 into 7. Okay. See here, do the multiplication. The same numbers are there here also. Here we done by the vertical and here we done the arrangement as a horizontal. Okay, students. Now, we will solve practice set 11, which is based on this prime factor method. Now, see the question. Factorize the following numbers into its primes. 32. Now, 32 at unit place. 2 is there means it is divisible by 2, no students? Yes, it is divisible by 2. 2 ones are 2. 1 is remaining, no? From 3 we subtracted 2, then 1 is remaining. And here 12 is there. 2, 6 is a 12. That's why here 16. Now, 16 is present in 2 table. 2 8s are 16. Here 2, right? And here 8. Now again 8 is present in 2 table. 2 4s are 8. Again 4 is present in 2 table, that is 2 2s are 4. Now 2 is a prime number, so 2 is present in its own table, 2 1s are 2. Now further division we can do, what students? No. So now see, 32 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Do the multiplication now. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16, 16 2s are 32. Okay. And vertical arrangement, horizontal arrangement also I don't see here. 32 is present in 16 table. 16 2s are 14, sorry, 32. And again this 2 right as it is, take the factors of 16. 16 is present in 8 table. 8 2s are 16. Now 2 into 2 right as it is, take factors of 8. 2 4s are 8. And again 2 into 2 into 2 right as it is, take factors of 4. 4 is present in 2 table, 2 into 2. Okay, students. Now we'll see the next example. 150 we have to take, sorry, second example is 57. 57 is present in only 19 table. No, students, it is divisible by 3. C 5 plus 7, 55 plus 7 is 12. 12 is divisible by 3. That's why divide 57 by the 3. Okay, see here, 57 divided by 3. 3 1s are 3, 2 remain 7. 3 9s are 27. So the factors are 3 into 19. Factors are 3 into 19. Now 19 is a prime number, so we can't do the further arrangement. That's why factors of 57 are 3 into 19. Now third one, see here, 23. 23 is a prime number, so it doesn't have any factor leaving one and the own itself. That's why 23 is equal to 23 ones are 23. Now next example, see here, 150. Now here I am doing the horizontal arrangement, students. 150 at unit place, 0 is there, so it is divisible by 2. 150 divided by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 7s are 14. Here 1 is remaining, 1 and 0 is 10. In 2 table 10 is there, no? 2 5s are 10. That is it. The factors of 150 are 2 into 75. Now 75 is there. 75 is not divisible by 2 at unit place. 5 is there. That's why it is not divisible by 2. Then take the test for the 3. That is 7 plus 5. How much, students? Yes, 12. 12 is divisible by 3, no? So 75 also divisible by 3. Okay. See here, 75 divided by 3. 3 1s are 3. 3 2s are 6. 1 is remaining. 1 and 5 is 15. 3 5s are 15. Means write 2 as it is and 75 factors are 3 into 25. Now 25 is present in 5 table, no students? That is 5 5s are 25. Write 2 into 3 as it is and take factors of 25, that is 2 into 3 into 5 into 5. The factors of 150 are 2 into 3 into 5 into 5. Now next one we will see factors of 216. Now see here, at unit place 6 is there, so it is divisible by 2, no students? Yes, it is divisible by 2. 216 divided by 2. 2 1s are 2. 1 is there in 2 table, 1 is not there, that's why write 0. 1 and 6 is 16. In 2 table 16 is there, that is 2 8s are 16. So the factors of 216 are 2 into 108. Now we have to take the factors of 108. 108 is divisible by 2 again, because at unit place 2 is there. 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10. And 2 4s are 8. That is, the factors of 108 are 2 into 54. Write first 2 as it is. 2 into 2 into 54. Now we have to take the factors of 54, students. 4 at unit plus 4 is there, means again it is divisible by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 1 is remain, 2 7s are 14. Okay, now the factors of 54 are 2 into 27. So the factors of 216 are 2 into 2 into 2 into 27. Now 27 is not a prime number, it is divisible by 3. So divided by 3, 27 is present in 3 table, that is 3 9s are 27. Okay, now again 9 is not a prime number, 9 is divisible by 3. Take the factors of 9, that is 3 into 3. So the total factors are 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, these are the factors of 216. Now, same examples I done by the vertical method also. These all examples we wrote in the form of the horizontal arrangement, and these same examples we done in the form of the vertical arrangement also. See 57, it is divisible by 3. By 3 into 19, 19 ones are 19, these are the factors. On the left hand side numbers we have to take as a factor, students, okay? Not right hand side numbers, only left hand side numbers we have to assume as a factors, okay? These are the quotients, we are dividing, no? That's why these are the quotients and these are the factors. Now we will learn that highest common factor. It's a short form is HCF. Highest common factor means what? That we are seeing now, students. The largest common factor of two or more numbers is called the highest common factor or greatest common divisor. The another name is greatest common divisor, that is GCD. Okay. So see here, the HCF of any two consecutive even prime number is 2 always. Remind that the HCF of any two consecutive even numbers is 2, and that of any two consecutive odd number is always 1. So we will see practice set 12, which is based on this. Question number 1, find the HCF. Now see the examples now here. First example we will see. Have to see that the factors of 25 and 40. Here we have to see that the highest common factor, and both should be divisible by the same number. Now see here, 25 and 40. 40 is divisible by 2, but 25 is not divisible by 2. So don't take 2. Now 25 and 40 are divisible by 3 or what? No, these both are not divisible by 3, so don't take 3 also. Now see 25 and 40, both are divisible by 4, no students? 5, no students? Yes, both are divisible by 5 because 25 is present in 5 table and 40 also present in 5 table. So, divide it. 5 5s are 25, no students, and 5 8s are 40. So, again, 5 and 8 both are present in any table of what? No, because here 5 is prime number. That's why these both numbers are not present in any table. Now, which number is there, students, here? Yes, only 5. So, the highest common factor of 25 and 40 is what? 5. Okay. Now, we will see the next example, that is 56 and 32. Now, first of all, we have to see that both numbers should be divisible by the same number. Now, at unit place 6 is there and here 2 is there, means these two numbers are divisible by 2. So, the both numbers divide by the 2. Now, here 2 2s are 4, 1 is remaining, 1 and 6 is 16, 2 8s are 16. And again 32 is divisible by 2. Just now we solved that example, 16 2s are 32. Now, see here, 8 and 6 is there. Again, it is divisible by 2, no students? So, divide the number by 2 again. 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. And here, 2 8s are 16. Now, 14 and 8 is there. Again, it is divisible by 2. So, write here, 2 7s are 14 and 2 4s are 8. Now, see, 7 and 14 are divisible by any number? No, because here 7 is a prime number, but 4 is divisible by 2, but we can't write. What is the condition? Both numbers should be divisible by the same number. Here 7 is a prime number and 4 is a composite number. That's why these are not present in any table and these are not divisible by any number. So, the HCF of 56 and 32 is 2 into 2 into 2. That is 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. Okay, what is the HCF of 56 and 32? That is 8. Now we will see the third example, 40, 60 and 75. Now we have to see that both all three numbers should present in same table. Now 40 and 60 are divisible by 2, but 75 is not divisible by 2 because at unit place 5 is there. Now, we will see that divisibility test for 3. 4 plus 0 is 4. 4 is not divisible by 2. Now, 6 plus 0 is 6. 6 is divisible by 3. And 7 plus 5 is 12. 12 also divisible by 3. But 4 is not divisible by 3. That's why we can't take 4 also. Now, let's see the divisibility test for the 5. Yes. Now, for what is the condition for 5 at unit place? The numbers 0 or 5 should be present. Now, here 0 and 5 are present in all three numbers. That's why these are divisible by 5. Okay. Now, write here 5. 5 8s are 40. Now, 5 1s are 5. 1 is remaining. 5 2s are 10. Now, here 75 is there, 5 1s are 5, 2 is remaining, and here this 5, 25, in 5 table 25 is there, 5s are 25. So now 8, 12 and 15 are divisible by any number, students? Yes, no, because 8 and 12 are divisible by 2, but 15 is not divisible by 2, and 12 and 15 are divisible by 3, but 8 is not divisible by 2. And 15 is divisible by 5, but 8 and 12 are not divisible by 5. That's why these all numbers are not divisible by common number. So, what is the highest common factor of 40, 60 and 75? Yes, the HCF of 40, 60 and 75 is 5. Now, we'll see the next example, 16 and 27. 16 and 27, there is no common prime factors in between 16 and 27. Why? Because see here, when we are writing 16 and 27, 6 is there at unit place, so it is divisible by 2, but this is not divisible by 2. And if we are taking for the 3, 6 plus 1 is 7, 7 is not divisible by 3. But 27 is divisible by 3. If we are taking 5, both are not divisible by 5. If we are taking 7, in 7 table 16 and 27 are not present. So, don't take 7 also. and in 11 table 16 and 27 are not present. That's why there are no common factors between 16 and 27. That's why the HCFA of 16 and 27 is 1 student. Okay. Now next one, see 18 and 32 and 48. Now these all numbers are divisible by 2 students. See at unit place 8, 2 and 48 is there. So divided by 2. 2 9s are 18 and 2 16s are 32 and here 2 2s are 4 and 2 4s are 8. Now we have to see that these all three numbers should present in one table only. 16 and 24 are present in two table but 9 is not present. 9 and 24 are present in three table but 16 is not there. Okay. And in 8 table 16 and 24 is there but 9 is not there. In these three numbers are not divisible by 5 also. That's why all three numbers are not divisible by any number. So what is the HCF of 18, 32 and 48? Yes, this is only 2. Okay. Now next number we will see 105 and 154. Now we have to see that these numbers are divisible by 2 or not. 104 is divisible by 2 but 5 is not divisible by 2 and 5 plus 1 is divisible by 3 but 5 plus 1 plus 4, how much it is? 10. 10 is not divisible by 3, so we will take for 7. 7 ones are 7, 3 is remaining here, 3 and 5 is 35, in 7 table 35 is there, no? 7 5s are 35. Now here also same thing, 7 2s are 14, 1 is remaining, 7 2s are 14. Now we have to see that 15 and 22 are present in any table or not. Yes, these are not present in any table, means common. Both are not present common in any table. So that's why the HCF of 105 and 114 is only 7. I hope students, all of you understood how to find the HCF of given numbers and how to factorize the given numbers into prime factors and which are the prime numbers, co-prime numbers, composite numbers. Okay, and twin prime numbers. In next session, we will see LCM and the application of HCF and LCM students. Okay, thank you.